more than that, we are going to describe the thing which are more important than all the experiment and the PCBs, because without them no one can do any experiment or no PCB or no industrial process can be made, which are the tools. The Tesca is introducing the basic electronics tool kit, which includes many of tools by which the students can use them and perform the experiment or can draw or make the circuits. This is the Tesca's toolkit of electronics toolkit. The order code for this toolkit is 1920-4895.3.9A. In this toolkit, there are many tools which are required using to describe the circuits and defining the circuits, which is our basic electronics tools. We will start with the soldering iron. This is a soldering iron. Basically, it works on the resistive load. As the power supply goes to the resistive elements, the iron heats up and so this is the power supply socket of this tool, and this is the bit which can be changed when it is rusted or damaged. In this, the supply is connected to a resistive load which generates heat. By this, one can use a soldering wire or soldering paste and do the soldering perfectly with this tool. Now, second is, this is the desoldering pump, which will be used when any component or any hole want to put in the PCB, or any component which will be required to remove from PCB. This desoldering pump will be used on the electronics tools. This is a general PVC tape to insulate any conducting wire which supply. These are the scissors which will be required to cut any of substance which or wire or any paper or tracings. This is the cap of this scissor, and these are perfectly insulated with this plastic covering. Band plier, you can see one can easily put any component on the PCB by grabbing the component with this band plier and easily solder it, or easily put the component in the complex situation. This is a nose plier, works same as the band plier, but it is not any bent solution, so the little components, the small components can be easily picked up with this also, which is also both the nose plier and band plier properly insulated, so one can not have any effect of shocks. This is a voltage tester. Now move on to the next section. This is the slide range spanner. One can set this spanner to required size, whichever nut or bolt want to be tightened or loosened. This is a simple wire cutter which can be used to cut any wire or hardened wire. This is the screwdriver set. In this, different types of screwdriving tools, and it is also a voltage tester because the testing unit is installed in this holder. So there are different combinations of screwdriving sets are provided in this. These are the drill bit set, and this is the soldering stand in which one can easily put the soldering iron when not in use. while working on the PCBs or electronic circuits. So now, or there is one more item. This is a electric blower which will be used to remove all the dust from the PCBs or electronic instruments. So now, one by one, we will use these instruments and I will demonstrate how to use the instrument from all these electronics toolkit. So now, we will do a small and brief demonstration of these tools, some of these tools. So first, we start with the line tester. This line tester basically used to test the line at the supply. Now, as I present, put this tester in this extension board, you can see a bulb is glowing in the inside the tester. So this is showing the line is present. As I switch off the extension board, the line is not present. So the basic function of this tester is to test the live line, or you can use to tighten the screws or bolts which are on the line or on the PCBs. Now we will use the soldering iron for second. This is the soldering iron. This is the soldering stand and this is plate for used for applying the soldering paste. The soldering paste can be placed here. This is the soldering wire which will be used to doing soldering. Now for using or soldering any component on the PCB like this resistor, we first have to make the proper cutting of this resistor. For this we will use the cutter. Like this to cut the excess wire. Now we will use the nose plier to bend the wire of this resistance properly. One can use the nose plier to place the resistance and other components on its position to do soldering, or we can do the same thing with this bend plier also, but bend plier uses when the any live circuit or any complex circuit is present, so that one can easily reach to the avoiding nearby circuits and place the component at its right position with this bend plier. Now with the soldering unit, we just apply the soldering paste on one terminal of this resistor and using the soldering iron and taking some soldering wire, put the resistor at the PCB and one can easily solder the component on the PCB. We can solder this on the other side with this soldering iron. So that's how you use the soldering iron and bend plier, nose plier and wire cutter and tester. Now this is the desoldering pump. When any component which is wrongly placed or damaged, we can use this soldering pump to remove that component. For this, we first charge this pump like this and remove and heated up and melted the soldering wire solution with this soldering iron. the excess of. Now when the component any has removed from its location and you see the hole that was present there is now blocked with the soldering solution. To remove this soldering solution and put the hole again in the PCB, we use this soldering pump. For this, first we charge this like this and heat the soldering paste and put it here, and we do again process. So heat and melt the solution like this. So you can see the holes are cleared, the solution of soldering is cleared from this, of any garbage which is excess remains in the pipe which can be removed by pressing this point to end. You can see the knob come out from this point and the solution which is dried inside this pipe can easily come out. For this scissor, any of wire which will be required, any of size or required size, can be cut with this scissor easily. And now you can strip this wire and use it with your components whenever you want to solder the component. Now the last section of this kit is the electric blower, which can be used to clean the apparatus which will on which any person is working, the dust and the small components of jumper wires like can be removed with this blower. So this is the blower and these are the different settings of this blower, and this is the on off switch of this electric blower. As I on the switch, the blower starts rotating. It is now at its first speed. As I increase the speed of blower also increases. The extra dust particles can be cleaned by using this blower. The PCB also can be cleaned from the dust by using this blower. So this is the electronic toolkit for general purpose of uses. So these are the all components that I have already demonstrated and described how to use them. So this is the electronics toolkits from Tesca. This is the all combination which are required in any electronics lab for ease of and understanding of and working on the kits with the students, and one can easily do the circuit components of electronics with this kit. Thank you.